in our pilgrimage.
Amen.
Holy One, we confess that we have wandered far from you. We have not trusted our promises. We have ignored your prophets in our own way. We have squandered our inheritance of grace. We have failed to recognize you in our midst. Have mercy on us. Forgive us and turn us again to you. Teach us to follow your ways. Assure us again of your love and help us to love our neighbor. Amen. Beloved in Christ, the world draws near to you, and all who call out to God shall be saved. And Jesus, God, comes to you again and again and gathers you under the wings of love. In Jesus' name, your sins are forgiven. God's journey with you and teaches you how to live in love. Amen. Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Our first reading is from Joel. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming. It is near, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness. Like blackness spread upon the mountains, a great and powerful army comes. Their like has never been from of old, nor will be again after them in ages to come. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me. With all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning, rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people. Sanctify the congregation, assemble the aged, gather the children, even infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her canopy. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord, and do not make your heritage a mockery, a byword among the nations. Why should it be said among the peoples, where is their God? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading is from 2 Corinthians. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time, I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation, I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, ruthful speech, and the power of God. With the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord,
Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you will have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room, shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look so dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
be to
you, O Christ.
Please be seated. In this season of Lent, we have an opportunity to reflect on our lives and the quality of relations we have with others. Your relationship with others. An opportunity to explore. Now, when you begin this process, this journey of looking at life around you and the people that God places in your sphere, you may come up with a lot of different emotions and reflections and feelings. You may come up with the feeling of love, maybe anger, maybe frustration or joy. Maybe hatred, but worst of all, maybe indifference. Now, with that said, who are the relationships that you may focus on? There are so many, you see. It could be your spouse, it could be family members, or friends, or neighbors, clients, co-workers, those amongst us at St. John, any number of relationships come into our life where we have this opportunity in different ways to give and receive love, sometimes passively, sometimes more actively. Would you consider on your journey strangers or those you might see on a regular basis but really do not know? Maybe there are people at the grocery store, or maybe those walking their dogs every day at 3 o'clock or something. As you continue this journey of exploring the nature of relationships, you might even consider people who are living in war-torn areas, like the Ukraine, like Algeria, like Chad, like Mozambique, or Tunisia. Sadly, just to name a few. Would you consider including those living in poverty and or suffering from oppression right here at home? As you reflect on this endless list of possibilities, does your attitude shift at all? If so, you might ask yourself why. Now, what and whom might I have missed? You may have noticed I did not mention God. Now, beyond these relationships, how do you want the world to see you? Is there only one you, or are there many different faces you or we put on to communicate with others? Different groups, different situations, and if so, why? Why would we have more than one face? In the end, in the time that we have between dust and dust, our life is a measure of the quality of relationships we experience with all of those, or some of those mentioned above. Now you might ask, in all of this, where is God? I would suggest God is everywhere. Can we see God's presence in all that has been stated? If not, why? It's hard to see God in everything just mentioned, but if it's hard to do that, it might be worthy in our Lenten journey to pray for the very eyes to see God in all places throughout the world. You know, it all starts with each of us. And to start this Lenten journey, my friends, I want you to remember and know that you are loved beyond measure, that you are gifted with the power to experience God's peace and to share that peace with others. Do you know that as you travel into the depths of God's peace, that you are fully protected? Do you know that you will find your true self in the midst of this peace, the depths of this peace? Now, before any amazing journey in ministry, Jesus would always say to his disciples, "Be not afraid." My friends, if you choose to explore this journey in this way, know that you are in my prayers. It's not an easy journey to take. There's so much to explore. And know, as your pastor, if you ever care to talk during this journey or beyond, please do not hesitate to give me a call. It's my privilege to serve you and to be there for you and to explore some of these deep, amazing questions of faith. In any event, if now is not the right time to take that journey, I understand. But if it is, know that I'm there. Maybe you've already taken this journey and you've explored all that I've just mentioned, and if so, I'd love to hear about that as well. In any event, I'm grateful to be your pastor, and I pray that during this season of Lent, that you will be uniquely gifted and blessed by the various gifts that can be found in a spiritually active life. Peace be with you. Now, I have one confession. This is the first time you've ever seen me try to read. But if anything I've said is of unique interest to you, you will find it in the newsletter coming up. Amen.
Of silence, we come to you, O Lord.
We come for acceptance. We come for community. We come for forgiveness and love.
In the stillness of worship, we come to you, O Lord.
We come for respite. We come for completion. We come for forgiveness and love.
dust to dust with each other. Remember that you are dust to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust to dust you will return. To dust you shall return. Now with my glasses on. Remember that you are dust. To dust you shall return. Accomplish in us, O God, the work of your salvation, that we may show forth your glory in the world. By the cross and the passion of your Son, our Savior, bring us with all of your saints to the joy of his resurrection. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Satisfies. Take and use what we offer here. Come among us and feed us with the body and blood of Christ, in whom we pray. Amen. Amen. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that renewed with the gift of baptism, we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so with all the choirs of angels, the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
On the night our Lord was betrayed, he gathered his disciples in an upper room in downtown Jerusalem. And as he gathered them there, he taught and he prayed and he reflected on his life with them. And he gave them comfort and direction for a life that would follow. And so before the meal began, he took bread and he broke it. He gave it to his disciples and he said, "Take and eat." And then after the meal was over, he took the cup. And he said, "This cup is my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this and remember me." We know that with the body and the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we are strengthened to become his hands and feet for a world that desperately needs this love. So together, let us pray the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. This is the body of Christ given for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Please stand.
Blessed Jesus, in this rich meal of grace, you have fed us with your body, the bread of life. Now send us forth to bear your life-giving hope to a world in need.
You are children of God, anointed with the oil of gladness and strengthened for the journey. Almighty God, motherly, majestic, and mighty, bless you this day and always.
Amen. Thank you.
in the footsteps of centuries of pilgrims, go now to embark on your Lenten journey. Consider how you may simplify your days so that you may travel lightly. Be alert to all that could sidetrack you. Notice that which beckons alluringly or with apparently greater urgency than the pilgrim journey Christ invites. Do not try to cover more than one good day's journey at a time. Know when to stop for food and sleep, so that the journey will not be too great for you. Walk humbly, knowing that the goal is not recognition, achievement, or reward, but simply to have come to know Christ and yourself more intimately. Be on the lookout for other pilgrims, caring for those who limp or fall, those who cannot see the way forward. Pilgrimage is richer in community. Go now. Place your hand into the outstretched hand of Jesus Christ. Allow the words of the story to guide you, and pray for purity of heart and mind.
Amen.
Amen.